Imagine a city where the streets sway with the tide, where food is harvested on floating farms, and where homes rise and fall with the ocean itself. By the year 2100, more than 800 million people could lose their homes to rising seas. Entire nations may vanish beneath the water. But instead of building higher seawalls or fleeing inland, what if humanity learned to live on the ocean? This is Oceanix Busan, the world's first government-backed floating city. A radical experiment designed not as a luxury project, but as a survival blueprint. And if it succeeds, it could change where and how humans live forever. Around the world, the water is advancing. The Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change warns that global sea levels could rise by up to 1.1 meters by the end of this century. That may not sound like much, but for coastal nations and low-lying cities, it's catastrophic. In Bangladesh, over 30 million people live less than 1 meter above sea level. Every monsoon, thousands of homes are washed away. In the Maldives, the highest point of land is just 2.4 meters above sea level. And by the end of the century, the country could cease to exist. In Jakarta, Indonesia, land subsidence and rising seas mean the city is sinking by nearly 10 centimeters every year. By 2050, one-third of Jakarta could be underwater. Even wealthy cities aren't safe. Miami, New York, London, and Shanghai are investing billions into sea defenses. But storm surges are getting stronger, hurricanes are more destructive, and the ocean keeps rising. The economic risk is staggering. The World Bank estimates that flooding could cause as much as $14 trillion in damages every year by the middle of this century. Traditional solutions like seawalls, levees, and storm barriers can only hold back so much. They're costly, temporary, and in many cases, they fail against nature's growing force. So instead of endlessly fighting the water, some architects and engineers believe it's time to embrace it. In 2019, the United Nations Human Settlements Program partnered with Danish architect Bjarke Ingels Group, MIT's Center for Ocean Engineering, and the design firm Oceanix. Their goal was to create the world's first prototype of a sustainable floating city. Not a cruise ship, not a billionaire's seastead, but a city for everyone designed to be scalable, affordable, and climate resilient. Their first test case is Oceanix Busan in South Korea, a pilot community covering 6.3 hectares, about the size of 8 football fields. Oceanix Busan is made up of 3 interconnected platforms, each anchored to the seabed, with room for housing, research, and community spaces. The design can later expand to 20 platforms, housing up to 12,000 people. Each platform is hexagonal, chosen for stability and modularity. Just like honeycombs, these hexagons can connect endlessly, forming larger districts as needed. Renderings show sleek wooden housing blocks, rooftop solar arrays, and lush gardens built into every platform. From above, the city looks like a geometric island, man-made yet harmoniously integrated with the sea. This isn't just an experiment, it's a survival strategy. The engineering challenges of a floating city are enormous. Platforms must withstand waves, storms, and typhoons. Oceanix platforms are designed to survive Category 5 hurricanes, with waves up to 7 meters high. Each platform is tethered to the seabed with tension leg systems, flexible enough to move with tides but secure against drifting. Solar panels cover rooftops, while wind turbines and ocean thermal systems generate additional power. The city aims to run entirely on renewable energy. Fresh water will be supplied by on-site desalination plants, while rainwater harvesting and greywater recycling reduce consumption. Food is grown on aquaponic systems that combine fish farming with vegetable cultivation. Urban farms on rooftops supply fresh produce. With enough modules, the city could feed itself. All waste is composted, recycled, or converted to energy. Nothing is dumped into the sea. Buildings are constructed from cross-laminated timber and bamboo, both strong and low carbon. The platforms themselves are made from a material called Biorock, which is grown underwater using minerals from seawater. Biorock is self-healing and stronger than concrete, making it ideal for marine construction. The pilot phase for Oceanix Busan is budgeted at around $200 million. Critics argue this is expensive for just 10,000 residents, but if scaled, costs per resident would fall dramatically. The vision of floating cities might sound futuristic, but for some countries, it is the only option left. The Maldives has already begun exploring floating communities with Dutch engineers, starting with a 5,000-home project near the capital. In Bangladesh, non-governmental organizations are testing floating schools and farms as prototypes for climate resilience. Pacific Island nations like Tuvalu and Kiribati are lobbying the United Nations for legal recognition even if their physical territory disappears beneath the sea. Even wealthy nations are experimenting with the idea. The Netherlands, a country built on reclaimed land, has floating neighborhoods in Amsterdam, while Japan is investing heavily in floating wind farms that could one day support entire urban platforms. But Oceanix Busan is the first attempt to build an entire floating urban ecosystem, backed by both a national government and the UN. If it works, it could provide a template for dozens of threatened cities worldwide. But if it fails, the dream of floating cities may remain science fiction. For all its promise, Oceanix faces immense skepticism. At $200 million for a pilot, critics say it is unrealistic for poorer nations. Who will pay for floating cities in countries like Bangladesh or Tuvalu? There are environmental concerns too. Anchoring large platforms to the seabed could damage fragile marine ecosystems. And then there is the politics. Who controls a floating city? If it expands into international waters, does it form a new nation? Who enforces laws? Maritime sovereignty is a legal gray zone. Some fear floating cities could become playgrounds for the wealthy, exclusive havens for elites, while poorer citizens drown. Oceanix insists this isn't the case. Their design aims for affordability, resilience, and inclusivity. But until thousands of people actually live on one, doubts remain. Still, the implications are enormous. Floating cities could expand habitable space for coastal megacities, offer refuge for climate refugees, create new economic zones in oceans, and even test technologies for future off-world settlements on Mars or in orbit. For the first time in history, humanity is building a city that floats. Not a ship, not an oil rig, but a true city with streets, parks, homes, and schools. Oceanix Busan may house only 10,000 people, but its success or failure will shape how billions respond to the greatest challenge of this century. Human civilization has always been tied to land, but as seas rise, land itself is shrinking. Oceanix Busan is humanity's first serious attempt to rewrite the rules, to build cities not on land, but on water. If it succeeds, it could change the course of human history. If it fails, we may be left with no choice but to keep building walls until the water finally breaks through. A city built to float, a blueprint for survival, and maybe the future of civilization itself.